So, as you all may know, I had the Galaxy S21 Ultra in hand, was using it as my main device for about a good month, and I sent it back. And I want to tell you the 5 reasons why I sent the phone back, because, I want to tell you the 5 reasons why I sent the phone back. So let's go on and get into it. So, here's the thing. The S21 Ultra was a good phone, right? It was a great phone. But there were 5 things that just kept me from really digging and diving into the phone as my main everyday device, or even getting rid of my iPhone as my, secondary device, whatever you want to call it. And the first thing was, I did not like Samsung removing the SD card. Now, in the past, I've always gone for the bigger size device, and I thought, I'll be alright without the SD card. I'll be straight. Nah, I didn't like it. I literally downloaded all my pictures, videos, and things like that I usually do, and my storage on the phone was well over 200 gigs. So 256 wouldn't be enough for me. But mind you, there was also the issue of the fact that Samsung takes up about 50 gigs of that 512 just for one UI. So what you're actually getting out of that 512 is more like 460 to 470 off out of the box. So it's not, I feel like consumer needs to be aware that if you're looking at buying that device, make sure that you get a ample storage, because 128 is enough, but I would always caution people, if you can afford it, to go to the 256. Second thing that I did not really care for when it came to the device, I had a lot of overheating issues. Now, when I used the camera and I recorded video, I would find that a lot of times, even recording in 1080p, 60 frames per second, I tried to use the Steadyshot a couple of times, I would notice that the phone would get really hot. And a couple of times, my camera app just completely closed. Now, another thing that happened with the phone, going into number 3, that just kind of steered me away from it: tempered glass screen protectors. Now, I had a film screen protector on my phone that I used, and it was just a substitute to hold me off until I decided to try to put a glass screen protector on there. But what I noticed was, even with that film screen protector, I was having a lot of issues with the in-display fingerprint scanner. There was a lot of misses, a lot of things that would happen that just kind of began to frustrate me. Now, I'm not saying it missed every time, but I would say out of 10 times, at least 4 it would miss. And that's, to me, that was frustrating compared to something like the 2D facial recognition, which, while not being secure, worked every time. So that was another issue that I had with the device. And the fourth thing that I had a problem with when it came to the phone was the cameras. Now, Samsung cameras have come a long way, and I know people in the comments are going to try to flame me, they're going to try to roast me and stuff, and that's fine, do what you do. I'll just hide you if you get ignorant. But Samsung cameras, while being good, have come a long way. The main issue is there's still a shutter lag, and I don't care what anybody says, you will miss moments if your subject moves when you press the shutter button. Now, I have used an iPhone in the past, I've used a Pixel 3a XL, I've used LG phones, I've used Motorola phones, OnePlus phones, and I have never experienced a shutter lag to the point where I did miss shots, and I know other people miss shots as well. And it's very frustrating when you're trying to capture something and you miss the moment because of the shutter lag of the camera. Now, I did try to turn off the vibration and the haptic feedback to see if that would change anything, and unfortunately it did not. So do with that as you will, but that was the other thing. And the last thing about the S21 Ultra that I did not care for, that ultimately led to me returning the device, was the battery. Now, obviously with the 5,000 milliamp hour battery, you're going to get great battery life and you're going to do really good things with the device if you tweak the settings to basically almost mute the phone. Now, using it at quad HD with 120 hertz, my battery would last me maybe 10 hours. And that's with my usage, using Google Maps, using YouTube, Spotify, podcast, Audible, things of that nature, just texting and talking, social media apps. I even had timers on my social media apps to limit the amount of time that I would use them throughout the day, because that was a nice feature of One UI. And I just, it just didn't work. It was very frustrating. So that is another part of this, of it that really bothers me. And I just didn't really care for the fact that I had to mute and die down the phone in order to use it at the best capacity. So those are the five things that ultimately led to me sending the S21 Ultra back and sticking with the iPhone. But am I done with Android? No, because here's the sixth thing. Yes, bonus thing. Here's the bonus thing about the S21 Ultra that ultimately led to me returning it. The Z Fold 2. Now, I don't have a Z Fold 2, right? I don't have a Z Fold 2. But here's the thing. When I bought my S21 Ultra, right, my initial thought process was I'll buy this device and I'll hold it for a trade-in, possibly for the Fold 3, or I'll just use it and maybe get a Fold and do a side-by-side of the two of them in the future. But the reality of it is this. Samsung has done such a good job with the Z Fold line, the Z Flip, Z Fold 2, that my interest is still piqued at wanting to try a folding phone. And knowing that the S21 Ultra, while being a good phone and while being $200 cheaper than last year, being $1,400, I'm looking online and I'm looking at different retailers and different places, and I'm kind of like, man, I could really just get a Z Fold 2 and get the best of both worlds, a folding tablet, a phone, you know, great cameras, because the cameras are not really that far off than what you get with the Ultra, minus the 108 megapixel, 100 times zoom, and things of that nature. But still, it's not a bad device that you can pick up. So I decided that while I'm returning my S21 Ultra, I still have a spare SIM and I still have an extra line available, I'm going to go ahead and pick up a Z Fold 2 because I want to see what the Fold is hitting on and I want to see if the money will be well spent when it comes to a Z Fold 3. Not to mention Samsung is doing the whole buy the Fold and you can use it for 100 days and then decide if you want to keep it or not. I think Samsung knows that people are going to keep the phone, but they're putting it out there anyway in case you want to just, you know, see if it works for you. So I'm going to give that a shot and see what happens. So we'll talk about that when that device gets in, you know, the guest room, because this ain't a studio. This is a two-bedroom apartment. So when the phone gets in the guest room, we'll talk about it. But until then, yes, S21 Ultra is no longer in-house. Sent back to Sammy. And it is what it is. I'll save it for another video. Anyway, I'm going to leave it there. Thank you guys for watching. Drop a like, hit me in the comments down below. You still have your Ultra, do you like your Ultra, you keeping it, whatever you're doing with it, and, you know, let's just talk about it. Catch you guys in the next video. I'm out.